Exercise 1.4, question number 11. You are given S of t equal to 1 by 2 g t square plus a t plus b, where a and b are constants. We have to check whether it is 1-1 function. So we take t1, t2, two values. S of t1 equal to S of t2, we assume. What is S of t1? 1 by 2 g t1 squared plus a t1 plus b. Right hand side, S of t2. So 1 by 2 g t2 squared plus a t2 plus b. That is, b will get cancelled both sides. 1 by 2 g t1 squared plus a t1 equal to 1 by 2 g t2 squared plus a t2. Now bringing all to the left hand side, 1 by 2 g t1 squared minus 1 by 2 g t2 squared plus a t1 minus a t2 equal to 0. Of g is taken common, 1 by 2 g into t1 squared minus t2 squared plus a into a is taken common, t1 minus t2 equal to 0. That is 1 by 2 g into factorize t1 plus t2 into t1 minus t2 plus a into t1 minus t2 equal to 0. We can take t1 minus t2 common between these two terms. So t1 minus t2 into 1 by 2 g into t1 plus t2 plus a equal to 0. But this cannot be 0. This is t1, t2 time. This is also the total quantity cannot be 0. So only this can be 0. t1 minus t2 equal to 0. So t1 equal to t2. So our assumption st1 equal to st2 leads us to t1 equal to t2. So f is 1-1 function. Then exercise 1.4, problem number 12. A function is defined, t of c equal to f, where f equal to 9 pi by c plus 32. You are given t of c equal to f, where f equal to 9 pi by c plus 32. So t of c equal to f, but what is f? This much. So instead of f, you can write this. So t of c equal to, instead of f, I have written this. 9 by 5 c plus 32. So t of c is 9 by 5 c plus 32. First submission, we want t0. So instead of c, we have to put 0. So t0 equal to 9 by 5 into 0, that is 0, plus 32, that is 32. 32 degree Fahrenheit. Then second submission, t of 28. So instead of c, we have to put 28. 9 by 5 into 28 plus 32. That is 252 by 5 plus 32. That is LCM 5. 252 plus 160, 5 into 32. Whole divided by 5. That is 412 by 5. That is 82.4 degree Fahrenheit. Then third submission, t of minus 10, that is 9 by 5 into minus 10 plus 32, that is 9 into minus 2 plus 32, that is minus 18 plus 32, that is 14 degree Fahrenheit. Now textbook answer is not correct for this. Then we have fourth submission, t of c equal to 9 by 5 into c plus 32. TC is given as 212, so instead of TC, we write 212. Now we have to solve for c. We are asked to find c. Multiply the root by 5. 1060 equal to 9c plus 160. That is 1060 minus 160 equal to 9c. That is 900 equal to 9c. That is c equal to 100 degree centigrade. Now, fifth submission. You are given f equal to c. From this relation, for f, I have put c. So c equal to 9 by 5 c plus 32. Or you can retain f, and instead of c, you can write f. Everything you can get in terms of f or in terms of c. I have put f equal to c. You can retain f equal to f, and instead of c, you can put f. But everything must be got in terms of f alone or c alone. Now multiply the root by 5. 5c equal to 9c plus 160. So minus 160 equal to 9c minus 5c. equal to 4c. That is, c equal to minus 160 by 4. That is minus 40 degree. So minus 40 degree centigrade is the same as minus 40 degree Fahrenheit. So minus 40 degree centigrade is the same as minus 40 degree Fahrenheit. Exercise 1.5, problem number 1, first solution. You are given f of x equal to x minus 6, g of x equal to x square. You have to find f dot g and g dot f. What is f dot g? What is the rule for f dot g? That we have to find out. To find the rule, we supply one x to f dot g. X is pakkathula g da irukku. So g activate aagum, f tharchamayathukku thoongum. G operates on x. What is the rule for g? G converts x into x square. So f of g of x, and g of x is x square. F dot g of x is f of g of x. This dot will go, it will become f of g of x. What is g of x? It is x square. Now you have to apply the rule for f to the element x square. F of x is x minus 6. So what is the rule for x? Simply subtract 6 from that element. Here the element is x square, so subtract 6. F of x squared is x squared minus 6. F of x is x minus 6. So f of x squared is x squared minus 6. The rule for f is, the bracket ku enna irukko adhe 6 subtract pandrom. If bracket ku x squared irukku, so x squared la 6 subtract pandrom. So we have finished finding the rule for f dot g. Rule for f dot g is x squared minus 6. That is, x will be converted into x squared minus 6 by the composition of two functions f and g, f dot g. Now let us find g dot f of x. G of f of x, that dot will go. G of f of x, rule for f of x is x minus 6. Now you have to apply the rule for g. Rule for g, simply square. So square it. G of x minus 6 is x minus 6 whole square. G will square the element that is put into it. Now what is the element put into g? X minus 6. So x minus 6 gets squared. We find f dot g is not equal to g dot f, because f dot g carries x into x squared minus 6, whereas g dot f carries x into x minus 6 whole squared. So f dot g is not equal to g dot f.